Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to part 2. Today we're going to focus on the practical tips for the Green Dean. And we spoke already a little bit about the climate change, right? That it's changing, and the scientists, they say that it's more sudden, more drastically, and more unpredictable nowadays. So we need to do something, yeah? And the reasons for that, that it's changing so fast, is because the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, right? We have excessive burning of fossils and things like that, and increased temperature, global warming, you have probably heard about that. And that causes the greenhouse effect, which this temperature will rise. And it also shows in the melting of the ice caps, that there is more melting of the ice cap, there is less ice, and therefore, because of the less ice, there is not much reflection of the sun back, so also increasing the temperature. And not to forget also rising of the water level, the sea level. Yeah, that's also posing some danger to us. So we human beings actually upsetting the balance that Allah placed for us on this earth. So now it's time, really, really time for us, necessary for us to look into renewable energy sources like the sun and the wind and water and waves and things like that to get our energy from. And besides that, now all humans also need to do their part. We need to do our part to change our lifestyle. Yeah. So today I want to focus with you on the practical things. Yeah. What you and I can do to change that. And especially Muslims also. We need to participate also, because we are 1/5 of the world population. Yeah. And Islam is a way of life, and it's actually a green deen. Yeah. It's like this way of life encourages us to take care of this planet. Yeah, we are the Khalifa, the vice regent, the steward, and we need to take care of this planet. Yeah, it's actually an act of ibadah. So it's part of our deen. Yeah, and part of our responsibility while we're on this planet. This earth is created as a benefit for us. It's a gift to us. Yeah, so we need to be careful about it and considerate. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he emphasized for us that we should be moderate and not to waste, and don't use more than we need, for example, and don't exaggerate, and be conscious of our environment. So we have the role model in Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And when we understand our environment and our role in the environment, we should be active in leading to change. Yeah? Be a green Muslim, yeah, and teach your children this as well. So what I would focus on is like 4 categories for now, in which we can make some changes. Yeah, it's very practical, and it's our very little changes. But the thing is, if we all do these little changes, it will make a difference, because we are all with millions and billions of people, right? So that's the idea. So the first area that I want to focus on is water. Being wise with water. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, do not waste water, even if performing wudu, on the bank of a fast-flowing river. Yeah, so there's a river in front of you, you're making wudu in it, and the Prophet said, don't waste water while this whole river is in front of you, right? And also we know from the example of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that he used very little amount of water. Yeah, in they have this little mineral bottles of 500, 600 ml, less than that. Yeah, he used just to perform wudu. And to perform ghusl, the whole bath, he used only like 2.4 liter. Yeah, and that's about it. Yeah, so can you imagine what we do nowadays, where we open the tap on the shower and we do just like half an hour on the shower, how many liters that will be? Yeah. So what we can do? We can first close the taps, when properly. So make sure it doesn't like still drip, drip, drip like that, right? And then close them also while brushing your teeth. Yeah, just like when you're brushing, just close it, and then later on you can open it again. While making wudu, don't let the water run. Yeah, just every time close it again. Yeah, in between, before you get your feet up and things like that. Also while doing washing vegetables or something, don't leave the tap open all the time. Don't open the tap on full capacity. That's usually not needed, unless you want to fill a whole bucket. But for usually it's not needed to open it fully. And taking a quick shower instead of a bath, for example. And when using, when you want to wash your car, you just use a bucket instead of a hose pipe. Yeah. When you have some leaking taps in your house, fix them. Yeah, so that the leakage stop. So these are a few of the examples that we actually easily can do. Yeah, and when you look at, for example, the city in Mecca, right? It's like because of the Zamzam well that this city came to in existence. Yeah, so our life always is involved with water. And nowadays there are still nearly 1 million people who don't access to clean water. Can you imagine that? We just opened the tap, right? But there are 1 million people who don't have access to this clean water. And children are still dying from water-related diseases until today. Yeah, so it's like we need to be more wise about the water, more aware, what we use the water. Don't take it for granted, all that water. We only have to open the tap. Yeah, some people cannot imagine that. So when someone asks you about Islam, speak about water, yeah, the importance of water and how we use water and how we are our awareness of water and things like that. Another thing what you can do is join a clean water campaign. So that's about the water. The second area is about power, green deen power, fuel and energy and things like this. Quran in chapter Araf mentions, O children of Adam, eat and drink, but waste not by excess, for Allah loves not the wasters. So Islam teaches us simplicity and moderation in all the things that we do. Yeah, so not to waste anything. And today we live in this world where the excessive use of resources is harming actually our environment. And that's actually one of the causes of this climate change. So what we can do? We can try to consume less. Yeah, this whole advertisement world is about getting to us to consume more, right? And more and more and more endlessly. But we have to think about, the thing we should reduce the usage of energy to produce all these products. We don't need so much stuff. Yeah, we have so much stuff and we don't need it. And so another thing what you can do in your house is, for example, switch off the lights when you're not in that room. There's no one in the room, don't keep the lights on. Yeah, unplug unnecessary appliances, which is not in use for some time. That will save energy. Using light-saving light bulbs. Yeah, and if you can afford it, install solar-powered energy sources. Right, that will help also. And it's not only that it will help for the environment and to reduce climate change, but you'll also notice in your energy bill, that it will reduce. Yeah, so it's had like twofold benefits. Another thing what you could do, if you live in a house with more than a few people, maybe you can just share the room where you all sit and do whatever you need to do, so that you for reading and praying and things like that, to minimize the number of vents and air cons and lights that you're using. Yeah, you just sit all together in one living room, for example. That will save again. Air conditioning is one of the biggest source of energy. Eh? It uses a lot of energy. And we should use that sparingly. We can actually open the windows from different sides that the wind blows and things like that. Also cool down your house. If you need to defrost something, instead of using the microwave, you can just defrost it overnight, right? Before you go to bed, you put it out of the freezer, and in the morning, it's defrosted, for example. Yeah, to decrease the use of energy. Another thing, for the laundry. Yeah, we all need to do laundry, but better to wait until you have enough laundry for a full load for the washing machine, right? That will also save a lot of energy. There are a few more things. Think about, for example, when you need to go somewhere, you need to make a trip. Think about it, if you can combine some trips together, that you don't have to go every time out for one little thing, but you combine. Or you carpool with neighbors or friends or things like that, to save energy. When you need to buy a new car, maybe you can buy a smaller car, if possible, or a hybrid or electric car, for example, that won't use like petrol, In for groceries, we can buy like local products, because when you buy local products, there's less transport costs involved, eh? Instead of like when it has to come from far places, from different countries and things like that. Walk to the masjid. Walk to the masjid instead of taking the car, yeah? Or use the bicycle, for example. And use public transport more often. That are also things that we can do, especially for distances under like 3 kilometers, yeah? The Prophet ﷺ, he actually said, like, shall I tell you something by the means of which Allah erases sins and raises people in status? And they say, yes, O Messenger of Allah. And he said, doing wudu properly at times when it's difficult to do so, taking many steps to the mosque, to the masjid, and waiting for prayer after prayer. That's constant readiness. That's one is in Sahih Muslim. So that's an hadith from the Prophet when he said, like, take steps to the masjid, yeah, that we walking to the masjid instead of taking the car. And actually, when you do that, walking to the masjid, you will also feel healthier, yeah, you're doing some exercise, you're moving, right, and our body is actually made to move. It will help you to lose weight, yeah, maybe you can also take, if you live in a flat or in a condo, maybe you can also take the stairs up instead of the lift, for example. And it's great for the environment, yeah, this is not only one benefit, but there are more benefits. And nowadays, people don't do so much exercises anymore. Many of us have like jobs when we sit whole day and things like that. So you see that diabetes on the rise, obesity is on the rise, high blood pressure on the rise, right? All these things are happening. So we need to move, yeah? We need to move. And that at the same time, we can do something for the planet, yeah? Okay, the third category now. It's the blessings of plants and the love for animals. Yeah? Today, there are actually many animals going in extinct or already extincted. And because of our actions, yeah, we're cutting all this rainforest and then the orang-utang don't have any place to go anymore, for example, right? And we have many animals, yeah, they are gone. And some are almost gone, yeah, that we have a few rhinos left, for example, in Africa and things like that. Now, every single creation of Allah has value. And every single creation of Allah has a purpose. Yeah? From the plants, the animals, the sun, the moon, the mountains, everything. Yeah? And everything in heavens and earth also worships Allah. Yeah? So we need to take care of those things. We need to be aware of those things. So the plants, for example, they are our basic source of food and oxygen. Yeah? For animal life and for human life. And without plants and animals, we won't have living resources, yeah? We couldn't survive. And we also value plants for like medicine purposes, right? And oils and perfumes and fiber and timber and things like that. So we can use it. We are allowed to use it. But don't waste. Don't take more than we need, yeah? And don't hit and brand and tease and torture animals, yeah? That's not part of our deen. Even if there are animals that we maybe some people don't like so much, like some people did, like the dogs, for example, yeah? The fact that the dogs have some impure najis for us doesn't mean that we're gonna hit them, yeah? Or throwing stones at them. No, they're creatures from Allah too, yeah? And animals are only allowed to kill for us when we use it, when we're gonna eat them, yeah? When it's used for food. And it should be like in a very, humane manner, very fast, yeah? That they don't feel pain. So that's about the animals. So what we can do in regard to plants and animals, feed and take care of the animals in your environment, yeah? That's one thing. Also, we should not chop unnecessarily the trees and the plants, yeah? Like I told you last time, right? It takes very many, many years for a tree to grow, eh? Before it's like meters high. And we chop it like in one day or in a few hours, it's gone, you know? And they have so much benefit for us. And then we just cut it because it's in the way or something, or it breaks, sometimes it breaks a branch or something and things like that. Another thing, we can plant some plants in our neighborhood, in the gardens, on the roadsides, eh? Like some bushes and things like that, or downstairs when you live in a flat, for example, or on the balcony, plant some herbs, yeah, or flowers on the pot on your balcony. Start a small vegetable or herb area in the backyard, in your backyard, eh? Or also on the balcony or downstairs on the flat. another thing what you can do with the family, take your ibadah outside and enjoy the creation of Allah. What I mean by that is like time for prayer. You can just go to the park and you pray there. Yeah, and you enjoy being in between the trees and being in the park and things like that. And we should actually walk more in the park instead of in the mall. Yeah, the mall is not beneficial for us. We are going to buy more things that we don't need, right? So walk more in the park. Yeah, and enjoy nature. There also sometimes are initiatives to plant trees, and you can participate in that. Yeah, there's a planting trees initiatives to increase the number of trees growing, because we need to do that because we're chopping so much away. Yeah, so we need to refill the amount of trees. Taking care of nature reserve parks. In Malaysia, we have quite a few parks, and taking care of them will be act of ibadah, actually. You can become an active member also, for example, from the Malaysian Nature Society, or you can be a part of like permaculture initiatives to make a difference, yeah, and to learn about how we can use this planet better, in a better way. For your food and groceries, you can buy seasonal products. Yeah, that you don't have to be imported from other countries. Yeah, so that you also save transport costs in that sense, and cook with fresh products. Yeah, like vegetables. That's better for your health. Yeah, and also it's better, much better than processed food. Yeah, it's like you eat whole food, and whole food is like food how Allah made it. Yeah, so instead of orange juice, you eat an orange. Yeah, instead of like all food that is made in a factory, which is not that's not real food. It's like we need to eat whole food. That's actually much better for your health. Okay, and now the last category, the fourth category, is about the land and about wastage. Now, for years, many people, they saw this planet simply to as a resource, as a free resource to increase their wealth. Yeah, and only now is that we realize, actually, that more people realize and experience that the consequences of this mindset, that we're actually destroying this planet. Yeah, and so since Allah made us a khalifa and a steward on this planet, we are required to take care of it and protect it from exploitation. So on the one hand, this world is made useful for us, yeah, in service to us, but on the other hand, we should not over-exploit it or abuse it or destroy it, right? So what there are a few things that we can do instead of like with in regard to the land and regard to waste. First, reduce. I spoke already about a little bit. The less products we use, yeah, the less resources will be used to make them. Yeah, so we should think about this consumerism, that we're buying too much stuff. Yeah, so only buy what you actually need. Yeah, and avoid wasting money on goods you won't use, because the shops will tell you, buy three, get four, right, and things like that to get you buying more. But do you really need four items of that particular thing, right? Just to save some money, or you just need only one, and then you end up with four of those things. Yeah. Also, when you go shopping, you can make a list. You know, I need this and this and this and this and this. Write it on the list or in your phone or whatever. Stick to the list. Then that avoids you too from buying more things that you actually don't need, right? Because in the shops, there's all this like things that they want you to buy, and it's like attractive and, oh, this is nice, right? They want you to buy more and more and more. Stick to the list. Yeah, that will help also for overspending and overbuying. You take your own cloth shopping bag, yeah, to the shop instead of all these plastic bags. Yeah, that's already very helpful. Yeah, so bring your own bags and use them. Another thing, we should rethink and re-choose, in the sense that buy items that can actually be recycled. Yeah, for example, you need batteries. Yeah, can happen. You use rechargeable batteries, so you can use them over and over and over again. Yeah, or something in glass jars, for example, or plastic containers that you can reuse. Yeah, so we should try to avoid disposable items, that are items that just for one-time use, right? Try to avoid that, because that will contribute to a lot of waste. Yeah. When we need to throw certain things, like batteries, for example, don't throw them in the in just in a normal garbage, because The batteries have a lot of chemicals in it, which are dangerous for the environment. They have acids and things like that. Also, cooking oil. Don't put the cooking oil into the drain, you know, because it will be clogged and it will be oily and it will be oil getting into the water system and everything. It's very bad. If you need to get rid of your oil, put it in some container and dispose it separately. Yeah. So things like that, we have to be more aware of the things that we're actually doing to our environment. Yeah. So there's so many things that you and I can do. Reuse and repair, another topic. So you buy and you use reusable containers. Yeah. Instead of using tin foil or cling wrap to store food, you use a container with a lid on it that you can actually reuse over and over again. And if you got some plastic in the supermarket, you got some plastic, use it again, those plastic bags for garbage, for example. Yeah. So there's a lot of things that we can use more than one time. Yeah. When you have some leftover food, maybe you can pack it nicely and give it to some people in need or feed it to the animals. Yeah. Just don't throw the food away. Yeah. That's really a waste. Especially when you think about all those people in other countries, like in Africa, that they don't even have food to eat. Yeah. So if you made too much food, then try to distribute it in a good way. If you have some pre-loved items, yeah, like clothes or toys or books, yeah, try to give it to charities or to schools or orphanages, so that it get a second purpose, yeah, second life. Try to also to fix broken items and appliances. Yeah, it's like sometimes you want to fix something, yeah, and there's something broken, and you want to get some spare parts. But unfortunately, sometimes they don't have spare parts anymore, so you cannot fix it. So that's a pity. But if you can, try to fix things. Yeah, you don't need to buy everything new all the time. Yeah, if something little is broken, maybe you can fix it. So at least try that. Yeah, that will help also. Paper. When you have printed paper and you don't need it anymore, the backside you can still use to make some notes, you know, or other things. Eh? Especially in offices also. Offices, they use a lot of paper. Yeah, unnecessary to print everything. Sometimes you don't need to print certain things. Yeah, and so be wise about that. Yeah, and some old paper also you can sometimes use for the children, you know, to make that they're gonna draw on, and things like that. Then about recycling. I will show you like the plastic. For example, when you use this, don't throw it in the garbage. Put it in your shopping bag, and when you go shopping next time, you put it somewhere there where to be recycled. And this one, for example, is for eggs, and it's made from recycled bottles. Yeah, it's mentioned here that it's made from this plastic. They made this into it again. Yeah, so it's recycled. So our resources can be recycled. Paper can be recycled also, and they make the paper from it again. So when you need paper, maybe you can buy recycled paper instead of new white paper. It usually is like a little bit brownish or yellowish, a different color, but it's good for the environment. Buy products which can be recycled. So better to buy something in a glass jar, yeah, than in plastic, for example, or tin cans or things like that. Buy things which can be which are made from recycled products. Yeah? That's also very good for the environment. If you happen to notice any illegal dumping or pollution or illegal cutting of trees, report it to the authorities. Yeah? And then last point, revive, meaning that try to not litter and dump. You know, it's even to the extent. Really simple things. You have a wrapper of a candy, you know, and you open it, you put it in your mouth, and you just throw it on the floor. Don't do that. Don't throw even a candy wrapper on the floor. Teach your children also. Don't let your children throw anything on the floor. That's actually that's how you revive this spirit of taking care of your environment and taking care of this planet. And in your family, create a culture of enjoying nature and caring about nature and things like that. So when you go to the park, point about these things. Sometimes you can even have like I've seen people, they come together and they organize some event and they're gonna all like hundreds of people and together they're gonna clean the beaches, for example, right? So there are many things that we can do. Yeah, there might, you might think, oh, that's all very little. Yeah, but all of us do these little things, it will make a difference, right? So that's the whole point. So to conclude, we should live a greener, more environmentally friendly lifestyle. It's not difficult. It really is not. We just need to change our habits a little bit. Yeah. So I hope in this video that I was able to motivate you into action. Yeah. Do something about it. As a Muslims, we should uphold the green deen, yeah, a green lifestyle, and become leaders in understanding and protecting our environment. Because Islam is the green deen. So now it produces green Muslims. Yeah. And so strive for the best. Your intention is of utmost importance, yeah? Because no deed will go unrewarded. Even these small little things, you bringing things to the recycle center, that will be rewarded, yeah? So you will see it on the Day of Judgment. Even if the results are small, yeah? It's like small little things, but still you get rewarded for it. So reduce, meaning you buy whatever you buy and use it all up. Yeah, then reuse whatever you can and then recycle when the things are ready to be disposed of and see if it can be recycled. So that's all for me today. Hope you enjoyed it and see you in next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.